Alright, dickheads, I'm your chunky messiah, Ethan, and I'm just here with some more of this here Total War Warhammer 2, the Beastmen, on that there PC. You know what, there's a part of me that thinks I should maybe say Mortal Empires when I do the introduction, but then again, I'm playing, but then actually no, Mortal Empires is literally in the thumbnail, and what the hell else situation could I be playing the Beastmen? In Total War Warhammer 2, other than Mortal Empires. Yes, more Mortal Empires. I'm gonna say, right now, you may notice that things are a little bit different, that I can't remember what the army composition is, but maybe our army composition's different. In fact, well, this is new. This isn't the same model or name as our previous Bray Shaman, although same school of magic, turns out, and we're not in the same place. Very simple reason for that, very simple reason, and that very simple reason is that basically there was a break between me recording episode 3 and me getting back to recording this that was like basically over, it was a good few days, because I had my very last thing of university stuff to do, and I did that, but it took me a couple of days so I didn't record, and by the time I'd come back, fucking Creative Assembly released the Amethyst update, which added the Amethyst Wizard to the Empire, the new hero, the Amethyst Wizard, who's actually incredibly cool looking. He's got his own, he looks like he's like new assets, and he's definitely using an animation set that at least none of the other Empire Wizards use. Very cool looking unit. But that, obviously, that free LC guy also came with a patch. And if you play Total War Warhammer, you know that whenever a patch comes out, it more or less breaks any save from before it, as well as breaking all the mods. So, it kind of screwed it. I thought I might have to give up on the campaign, but then I remembered that because we aren't exactly building an empire here, we're just kind of developing until we start, like, actively trying to wipe people out. And it was only, like, 3 videos in, I could, like, fairly easily just start another Beastmen campaign and get to more or less the same point. So, I'm at more or less the point we were at last time, I think, in terms of development. I've just unlocked the Rude Burrow, which allowed us to recruit Gorherd and Gorherd with shields. Strangely, this genuinely surprised me. The Gorherd with shield is actually slightly less expensive, both in terms of immediate recruitment cost and upkeep. I assume, because while they have shields, you can see that they do have noticeably higher melee defense, but they've got considerably lower charge bonus, lower weapon strength, lower melee attack. So, yeah, the Gorherd do have mostly better stats, they're just a bit squishier. I could have come back in at more or less exactly the same point as we were last time, which was, I think, the turn before we were going to get this built. But it occurred to me building that and recruiting these guys would be me sat here doing nothing for a while, so just kind of skipped ahead. Right, well, we've done that now. I believe I actually also have a mission that inexplicably wants me to raid here. Yes. So, get into a bit of a raiding stance here. And, actually, what does raiding stance do to us? Vigor, winded. Well, it doesn't say that that Grunberg still needs to be here, so fuck it, let's also attack Grunberg. Oh my, look at that beautiful balance of power. I presume it's because we've got a lot of gauze. Actually, there's a thing, what's the, oh yes, they don't half beat those guys in most stats, don't they? Yeah, they beat them in, I think, everything except for melee defense. Right, let's have a bit of a fight. Let us have a bit of a fight. Also, if I sound a bit out of it, it's because I'm a bit ill today. Not been sleeping well, feeling sick. Today's normally the day that I'm at my vampire game. But I was sick and I'm sick and various other things came up that meant that other people were having trouble getting there. The game was up to starting late, and because of the confluence of bullshit that was going on, yeah, decided to skip it. So my apologies if I seem a bit out of it or a bit peculiar. Also, be happy watching this, actually, because this is going to be one of the few times in the history of my entire channel, I think, when actually these videos are going to be coming out more or less shortly after they recorded, because obviously there was a big gap in recording just after I finished Vampire the Masquerade, Bloodlines, and then there's been another gap while I was recording this, so I ran out of backlog videos. So, yeah. I've also, I should say, turned on a mod that I didn't have turned on, because for some reason, even before the Amethyst update, it said it hadn't been updated, which is a Settlement Pack 2 for GCCM. For some reason, that one just hasn't been updated since the Prophet of the Warlock came out, despite the fact that all the other constituent parts of that mod pack have been updated. Doesn't seem to be causing any problems, but then again, this is the first campaign I've played since the update, because I completed my Lizardman campaign just before it started. Okay, what we got here? It's looking a bit dead. It's looking a bit grey and ashen, or brown and ashen rather. I'm trying to think. Is this chaos corruption? Is that what this is? Because I seem to recall that if you fight in areas with high chaos corruption, it can affect the generic battle maps. Is that what this is? I can only presume that's what's going on there. We're also just going to quietly leave the harpies over here. We don't need the harpies today. Same with those horrible dogs. Just leave them alone. Let them rest. They got beaten up in my siege of, I believe it was the village of Helmgart. Horribly beaten up in that siege. Almost lost them. I say siege. Yeah, let's just put our guys down. How many? That's still 6, isn't it? Yes, I just replaced my my normal dudes with these guys. You know, I felt like because of that greater charge bonus that the Ungar Spearman Herd without shields gets, I thought of keeping them as my front line, but these dudes have to soak up spears. Yeah, not spears, arrows. So decided to swap them out for the Ungar spear with shield, the Ungar Horde with shields. Get good old. What did I call you? I actually got around to giving this guy a custom name. Yeah, Fulgor Shadow Drinker. Seemed appropriate. Seemed appropriate for him. Also, I am still routinely kind of horrified by the sheer size difference between the Beastmen and normal humans. It's consistently baffling. I kind of want to see them compared to a Norskan Marauder, though. I feel like the Beastmen size-wise might be more in line with the Norskan Marauder. I mean, probably not their heroes, because these guys are huge. Then again, this dude is particularly massive, and that dude's... Is that just gauze? Is it just that gauze are that size? It doesn't seem like gauze are just that size. Also, yep, look at how much more intimidating the gauze are than the slightly pathetic ungauze. Ah, but then again, that's why one of them's in charge and the other one isn't. That's why these guys are the proper gauze. Which is more or less, actually, there's more similarities between orcs and beastmen than you might necessarily expect. And one of them, although you might disagree with me on whether or not this actually counts as a similarity, is that they both kind of form their society off of some kind of faint notions of what is and is not proper for their species. It's why literally you get gauze, which are really the way you start getting any level of respect or being treated at all passably well by the rest of the Beastmen, is when you gauze and above, and the ungauze are absolute garbage, because they're just a bit too human. I mean, you can kind of tell that looking at them. Although this game doesn't do a good job of displaying just how weird ungauze can be, because literally Beastmen, and it's described regularly actually in the books, though not, from what I understand, not particularly well displayed by the tabletop models. Beastmen can be like no end of weird combinations of shapes and heads and all sorts of things. Like they can have beaks, they can have horrible chicken faces and all sorts of nasty shit. Can Beastmen be, but they're not a proper Beastman. They're not properly liked by the other Old World Beastmen unless they are unless they are very specifically gores. And the ungores are literally just a general term for anything that isn't one of the respected kinds of beastmen. Because it goes, I think basically everyone else listed as ungores. You know, that includes elephant-headed people, chicken-feeted dudes, like, shit like that. They're all just non-entities. They're just bullshit, garbage, why would anyone care, no one loves you kind of situations. Then you get your gores, which are, not these chaps, which are chaps like the Bray Shamans, but more specifically, let's just have a nice look at them since they're a new model. I mean, you can see why you'd not want this coming towards you, wouldn't you? Jesus H. Christ. But yeah, then you get these dudes who are very specifically cloven, hooved, and goat-headed. Although, I think cow-headed as well is also accepted, even on these smaller gores. And you also get Bestigors, which is basically what this dude is. This is a model that's more or less, I think this guy is more or less just straight out of the Bestigor unit that's just been added by a mod to be an officer here, which makes sense. I mean, the Bestigor would be in charge. Although personally, I would have put a gore in charge of the ungores instead of just a slightly bigger ungore. But yeah, but I believe also that Morghur is probably technically a Bestigor. Because I think Bestigors are just bigger versions of gores. I think that's genuinely all they are. It's kind of bigger, arder gores. And you also get, like, Minotaurs, who are technically a different species, but because of how fucking big and stompy they are. They are trek with the same respect as a gore. And yep, that's fucked them up. I love that spell. That, what the hell is it called? Is it penumbral pendulum? Yeah, the penumbral pendulum. What, just absolutely one of my favorite spells in the game. I fucking love it. You know, let's... There we go, give them all the target. But you do charge in there. And you don't actually go and fight them, is my suggestion for you. And you lads. Although actually, put you guys in charge of chasing down the enemy general. But yeah, I believe when you get to the Bestigors, then it starts becoming, you know, who's in charge of the actual war herd. And the Bray Shaman are always very much, very respected for basically the same reason that, an Orc Shaman is. He's a religious leader, of course he's respected, do you know what I mean? It would be weird if he wasn't, is basically the rationale there. Oh, fuck it, let's get the Ungar Raiders in here, on those crossbowmen. Although, from the looks of it, those crossbowmen are gonna fucking, yep, they've... Didn't lose a man, already started running, I don't think. We didn't even get, the Gors didn't even get in a fucking combat, did they? Which is a bit of a shame, they're gonna be very upset, they didn't get to whet to their axes. Although, what's your running speed? Ah! A lot! Yeah, okay. They will get to wet their axes. There you go. Seriously, it's genuine. Like, I mean, you can tell this faction is just the... Yeah, flank them in... The Beastmen are flank them in melee, the faction, aren't they? Jumping fucking Jesus. No, fuck it. Go and engage. Actually, yeah, I want to see the size difference between you. Actually, turn off the UI. Let's get ourselves a nice... There's something that feels almost tragic about watching this in slow-mo. Hang on. Jesus. Yeah, you guys are, like, a lot bigger than them. Fuck, get your arm knocked off by a headbutt.
Oh,
I mean, chasing down the enemy is very in character for the Beastman. I keep wanting to, every single battle we do, I keep wanting to do my, my classic thing of forming them back up into a, like a marching, into a column to march, which, you know, makes sense, because these guys are definitely moving on after this, but, and, the Beastmen's inherent distaste in regards to order, you know, puts me off. But yeah, I believe once you get past Bestigors, you get Bray Shaman, who are separate off because they're religious leaders, so of course they're respected, but after that, I think basically it's just a matter of who's the toughest. Can, you know, which Bestigor can beat up enough other Bestigors to get respected, I think is more or less how it works past that, beyond that stage. Same with the Minotaurs. Yeah, because I think Minotaurs can be in charge of Warherds. Not as common as a Bestigor being in charge of a Warherd, but it can happen. Centaurs, I've got no idea. I don't think we've seen Centaurs yet. They're essentially this faction's equivalent of cavalry, which are, as the name kind of... The name sounds like centaur. I think I need to tell you what the Centaur are. I do know this about the Centaur, actually. From what I recall correctly, the Centaur are kind of sad sacks, like, as a species, which is just kind of peculiar. I think I remember thinking that I may be wrong. Please correct me if I am wrong about this, but I remember reading somewhere that they're described as being almost constantly looking for alcohol because their heads hurt and just they're angry about things. Like, they're more, but they always sound more sulky and sullen than the fucking, like, primal fury of the Gauls and even, like, some of the Ungars and the Minotaurs. The Centaurs sound, like, belligerent and annoyed more than they do, like, the impressive kind of angry or even the fun kind of angry that orcs get. I don't know. I think that's true of Centaurs, but like, don't quote me on that. But I believe that's the case. Very, very amusing. There is also the peculiar thing of that, again, something that's not shown in this game is I believe you can also get Warherds that just have human mutants in them, like shit that aren't even Beastmen. Just like, it's a very common thing actually in the Empire. In the human empire, where you will actually just get huge swarms in certain places of essentially either populations of humans who just kind of went feral and have been like mutated by exposure to like Warpstone or by Chaos Worship, or you'll get mutants who were like born weird and their parents threw them out and they grew up feral or were taken in by Beastmen bands or by Chaos War bands. But, yeah, a lot of the time the Beastmen, even lower than the Ungars, they'll just have, like, mutated, deranged humans running around that are literally used as a meat shield. The problem with the Beastmen is that this was when they were made, the other Beastmen in this game, is they were made at a time when Creative Assembly's gotten a hell of a lot better at essentially it just making shit for Total War Warhammer. Like, every single DLC... Like, the DLC in hindsight for Total War Warhammer 1 was pretty fucking disappointing until Norska. Do you know what I mean? Like, Norska was fantastic, but until Norska, it was, like, pretty solidly disappointing DLC. And almost all the DLC for Total War Warhammer 2 has been absolutely fantastic. And since Total War Warhammer 2, CA have been a lot better at adding kind of more interesting units and more complete rosters, whereas with the Beastmen, infamously, they didn't have a particularly complete roster. Like, I can see not wanting to add a cackling bunch... Sorry if you can hear the fucking dog barking downstairs. But I can see not wanting to add, like, a cackling swarm of mutants to the game, considering that, like, essentially in the Ungars, the Beastmen already have a passive ability... Speed, charge bonus, melee attack. Yes. That's fine by me. That's been given a fall guard. Okay, that's fine. You know, I'm immediately concerned that he's gonna march up and try and beat us up. Oh, he does have Knights of the Blazing Sun. How the fuck does he have Knights of the Blazing Sun? I suppose he's got an entire province and it is like turn... No, that seems a bit early to have Knights of the Blazing Sun. I mean, we'll try and take him if he does march up here. That'll be, you know, we might actually get a fucking field battle for the first time in the game. So far, we spent our entire time running away, but honestly, just because we've got gauze, I think we have a much better chance of actually standing up to an army rather than a garrison. Then again, this is quite literally, from what I understand, this is the, I can fucking see you up there. I can see you hanging out. Queer green skin. Really weird that you don't have a word in your language for green skin. Scarsnake, what do you want? A non-aggression pact. Really? Can I get you to agree to that without me paying you? Yes, I can. Cool. You know, I was kind of looking forward to beating up the greenskins, but for now, I think that's probably a good idea. Because I wouldn't want to get the greenskin. I wouldn't want to get the greenskins jumping on me. And actually, if the greenskins start moving in and taking over the ruins of the Empire cities we're destroying, of the Empire garrisons of the Empire. Yeah, the Empire settlements we're destroying. That'll actually give us somewhere to get our health back. To what the hell is the word for it? It's not reform. It's replenish. Yes, replenish. To replenish our units. Right. Hello, my good man. How much Fearbach? I believe this is a unique lord from the legendary lords. Mixer's Legendary Lords mod I've got, which gives basically every Empire faction their own, their elector count. What time are we on? Cool! Let's have a proper fight! It's not in our favour, but then again, when's the last time anything has ever said it's in our favour in this fucking game? This game seems to think the Beastmen are absolute trash tier, no matter what's going on. Although, having said that, all the times that it has put us in horrible negatives, we have had an army made up basically entirely of Ungors. However, at the same time, we've also won all those engagements with very few casualties. The only units, I think, that are going to give us any trouble is... well, those great swords aren't too clever, but... Yeah, those great swords might be an issue. We can get rid of Helmut here by just sicking Morghur on him. That'll probably do for him, I imagine. Or at least tie him down for a while. Yeah, it's those two units of Knights of the Blazing Sun that I'm concerned about. That's what's gonna fuck us. That's what's gonna ruin our evenings. That's what's gonna sod our days. I mean, also the crossbowmen are gonna be annoying as Christ. They're going to be incredibly irritating. Is this the same battlefield? I think it is. Oh good, no winds of magic. Well, I only wanted to use Penumbral Pendulum the once, so... There we go. That is what we in the trade call a lie. I don't think this is the same map, I think it's, it's just generic Empire countryside, I suppose. With, actually, that same brown. This has got to be because of Chaos Corruption, there's no way. Especially given the fact that everything's on fire when we go back to the campaign map. I've always enjoyed how kind of absurd the Chaos Corruption effect is on the campaign map. Like, compared to other forms of corruption, like, I mean, the Vampire Corruption ain't exactly subtle, but it's not as over the top as the Chaos Corruption one. And then you also get the Skaven Corruption, which, considering how loud the Skaven tend to be, it's a very subtle effect. Just, you know, some warp stone appearing on the surface, as if warp stone just erupts out of the ground wherever Skaven happened to be. I mean, they fucking wish that. They wish that's how that worked. Oh, whoops. You don't have Stalk. Ooh, doesn't that just put me in a pickle? Right, okay. Okay, well, we'll hide you there. You lads. That's a big fucking rock there, isn't it? You lads will hide there, and well, ideally... I don't know, maybe we'll be able to... If we pull you guys back... Well, I want to keep them there to make sure the enemy actually knows exactly where they are. That's a fair thought, if I do say so myself. You guys have stalks, so you can do whatever. And... You know, I'm also gonna keep... Now I'm not going to keep the harpies out of this. They can harass the archers. In fact, actually, that's also what I'm going to keep the Chaos Warhound. So I'm going to keep both of you up here for. So you can just go and harass the archers once the enemy formation has moved in. It's not the most clever of tactics, really, just having a completely flat line of spearmen. But fuck it, it's worked so far. Start battle. Okay. Get everyone in a position, and ideally, let the enemy charge. Well, let the enemy basically put themselves in the position where our Gors are going to be able to. Charge their silly asses down on them from up here. Hopefully. Flanking and ambushing, it is what these guys do. Wait for the enemy to get in the wrong place. Hidden units are revealed. God damn it. Nope, get back. Nope, run away. Nope, you get yourselves back. You get yourselves back in those fucking trees, e fucking immediately. You understand me? Okay. Yeah, they're starting to fire there. Those gauze look like they might get spotted. So let's shift you up and to the left. Wait, seriously? Wait, no, stop. Seriously, you guys just went off on your own. I mean, also, you don't look like you're from Talbotland. Is that how that's pronounced? Talbotland? I've very rarely said that out loud. Shit. I don't think I've ever heard anyone else say it. But yeah, you don't look like you're from Talbotland. You look like you're from Astalia, but let's put that to one side. You guys just abandoned your... Then again, I guess all you can see is some harpies. But still, just fucking off to the far left. Just pissing off somewhere else. Yeah, it'll be fine. Don't worry about it. Oh, hello. Oh, that'd be a lovely thing if that goes off at the right time. Ah! Yep. Okay. Not the absolute perfect time, but it fucking did it, didn't it? Jesus, people were cutting off by it, man. You good at single combatants? Nope, you good against multiple. Okay. I really need to remember that overcasting's a thing I can do. I always forget that it exists. Okay. Let's get you guys heading out there now, and it's looking like, yep, you dudes are charging, so let's, counter-charge, I suppose, or meet the charge as head-on as we can. And you, dear Morghur, go beat up our friend there, and you, my lad, stay back there. We don't need you getting hurt. You are my precious. What is his melee stats like? Because I'm gonna be honest with you, I wouldn't put it past this game to make him a surprisingly tough melee fighter, despite being a wizard. Nah, he's garbage. Yep, makes sense. Okay. Sorry, I just wouldn't put it past this game to have made that decision. Do you know what I mean? It just seems like the kind of choice this game would make. Okay. And you chaps. Let's hope that goes well. I really need to start, like, watching these replays back, just because I imagine those guys rushing out from the little hidey hole there. It'd be a lovely image. Here, I'm gonna send the warhounds elsewhere, but you get to keep harrying those crossbowmen just so they don't turn back around. Okay, well, that charge hasn't gone well. Oh, fuck it. Just rush him. I like that. They were winning. You know what? I can give them that. They probably were winning slightly before this happened. Having said that, the fucking Gore Herd's losing again, despite the fact that they're fucking surrounded. Hang on a minute. It's just, yeah. What's that make there? Yeah, melee attack of 6. The great swords are fucked. Okay. Oh, bugger. They've eaten shit, haven't they? Oh, well, makes sense. It's more or less what I was expecting. Although, oh no, please don't. And they did. Okay, well. We're winning on other fronts. Just not on this one. Okay, if we get some gauze in to assist them, then these spearmen will be able to assist the rest of the gauze. What is going on in the rest of the battlefield? You are losing. Like, I'm sorry. Is a gauze garbage? Is this something that I? The gauze are somehow losing in like several separate confrontations, and I don't understand how they're losing in them. Fucking Knights of the Blazing Sun. Raiders, do me a favor. Fill them full of holes. Cheers. Yeah, seems about right. Okay, you gauze aren't doing anything. So you should... fuck it. Just... Just surround the Knights of the Blazing Sun, just for the love of God, find a way to kill them. And then if I could get those great swords rendered useless again, that'd be fabulous, thank you. Sorry about me going quiet, I am just having to figure out how to actually win this battle as the friggin' Beastmen, and it's, well, this kind of well, I've not played much Beastmen, let's be blunt about it. I'm not great at it, not played them very often. Plus side, hopefully our units should be able to, catch up with the, fleeing ranged units.
Dark beasts! Mongols!
Although, I can feel a lot of re-recruitment coming up. I can feel I'm gonna have to recruit a lot of Ungors back, and basically all my Ungors and all my guys. I'm gonna have to re-recruit the entire fucking army, from the looks of it. Swear to God, I'd better get money enough from this to make up for the cost. On the plus side, the Knights of the Blazing Sun are all entirely concerned with beating up Morghur more than anything else. However, on the negative side, he is actually losing that fight, now that I look it up. Which is a concern. I am bad at managing this many units, man. I'm also increasingly baffled by the sheer inability of almost all of these Gore units to even face down fucking missile units in melee combat. Like, how are these guys combat even in melee against crossbowmen? They can't be this bad. I mean, that just seems absurd. It seems that every 10 seconds, something reforms somewhere. What isn't running right now? Who isn't running? Okay, you're not running, even though you entirely should be. You fucking Knights of the Blazing Sun, yeah, you better fucking start running. Okay. Fuck me. Okay. I don't really do this for the Beastmen, it feels wrong, but you know what? Let's have a quick look at the situation our army's in right now. Because I don't want to run these dudes anymore, largely, because it just won't go well. Like, I'm not, these guys will, I think, collapse and die if I try and make them run anymore. So let's just have ourselves a bit of a looky-loo at the state of our army. The first fielding of the Gores. Because my guess is that I'm going to be really upset about how comparatively small the army looks. Despite how, Is that just a random skeleton that we happen to be fighting over? Because it looks a little bit like we were actually fighting over the skeleton. That was like the aim of the conflict. My Chaos Spawns still here? Yes, they are. Good, 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 good. Don't want to lose my lovely Chaos Spawn. They're lovely. They've also got regeneration. Yep, means they are just kind of quietly healing while that goes on. As is Morghur, I believe. At least he should be. Yep. Just quietly healing. Quietly healing while the battle goes on. Although, you guys aren't exactly going to spawn any new dudes, are you? No, you Resident Evil 2 boss fight rejects. I swear to God, if you break and run when the fight's over, there will be hell to pay. I don't even know where the... What were you guys chasing? I mean, you must have been chasing something. You don't disappear off into the woods unless you're chasing something. Yeah, that's a pretty pathetic shambles of an army. Looks like... I've only actually the only units that routed, and I think they did route are two units of Ungor Raiders. Might as well save the replay of that. Because at least there was one good shot there. Yeah, losses 828. Yeah, we lost a lot of dudes. That really, really didn't go too well. I mean, looking at it, the Chaos Spawn did fairly well. And, yeah, as I thought, it was the fucking Knights of the Blazing Sun. I probably could have done more about them. That was just generally just me not paying enough attention to the battle. This is always the problem. I'm not as bad at Total War as I seem to be in the videos. It's just I get, like, horrifyingly distracted by talking. So things tend to just go incredibly badly. Though, yeah, these two Gore Herds didn't half get a lot of damage in. It's like 112 dudes killed, 126 dudes killed, 143 dudes killed. Fucking Harpies also did a pretty good job. In fact, I think they got the fifth largest number of kills, I think. Although, given how many units got about that many kills, I think that's officially the point at which it no longer stands out. Considering, basically, you could just throw a rock at the Ungor Raiders and you're gonna hit someone who got around the... Oh no, 64! Yeah, that one unit did weirdly well. I don't know why that's probably the fucking one that was off chasing crossbowmen is probably why that one did quite well. Yeah. I need to pay more attention to the goddamn battlefield. Fuck, I just need to pause it more often. I get distracted wanting to look at cool things. It's always been my problem with this game. It's definitely also going to be a problem when Total War Three Kingdoms comes out. I'm just going to be like, ah, cool, what happened here? And then, like, meanwhile, my forces are screaming and collapsing and everything's going horrifyingly wrong. Everyone's dying the worst possible death. And I'm just there staring gormlessly at what's happening. Eh, sounds about right. Also, sorry, I just pressed a button on my phone and realized that the sound was still on the phone. So, yes. I need to turn that sound off when I'm attempting to be subtle while recording a video. Oh, fuck, I forgot. I was doing that thing where I'm supposed to be reading the Ibikioska out, wasn't I? It's still under my desk. Next episode. I'll get back on that. Next episode. Yeah, what can we get here? Units replenished by 4% or Dark Favor. Yeah, sacrifice captives. Yeah. Sacrificing the captives is gonna do us, we're gonna do a lot better by their sacrifice than we are, leaving these dudes alive. Also, Gift of the Gab. Oh! It's a unique trait. Attribute Rampage. Enemy lords in local region. So what? He causes... Ruinous rituals, ruinous powers look down upon us with ire, lord. Perhaps we were not diligent enough in sowing catastrophe. Perhaps you do not care. Perhaps... You do not care. If you do, a sacrifice of warriors should appease their dark desires. If you do not, then the herd awaits. Spare the warriors. Fuck them. And we got some bonus cash as well, so things aren't entirely bad. However, I think that I am going to just... Just quietly disappear up here into the woods where no one goes and start gluing my units back together. Okay, I just need to recruit new ones. Are you? Not going well. Okay, you get glued onto him because he has... He's actually worth a shit. It's gonna take him three turns. You get glued onto him. Three turns, two turns, okay. You glued onto him, you glued onto him, and you two get glued together. And then you just get gotten rid of, because you'll take 68,000 million years to come back. One, two, three. Because you guys are... You know what, actually, no, we won't get you guys first, we'll get the cheaper dudes first, so actually make the most money, so... One, two, three, four... There we go. Go in that, go precisely in that order. And we should be good again in... Is that three turns? Isn't that basically how long it's gonna take everyone else to... I mean, you're also screwed. But I can't replace you, so... Deal with it, I guess. Although, on the plus side, I suppose, considering I do currently have this, Jabberslythe battle event, that does actually mean you guys are all coming in at a higher unit rank, so that's good. Alright, well, I think we're going to call it for that episode, considering we're about it has been 45 minutes. The next episode, I won't actually make you sit through the turn timers. What I'll do is, when I start the next episode, is I'll basically just sit here, let the turns tick over. And then if anything important happens, like say if we get discovered, or if we get attacked, or an event occurs, I'll start the episode then. But, yeah. We're done here for now. Bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I might not have, but then that's kind of irrelevant. I'd make the stuff, not watch it. Anyway, big thanks to the names that are and have been scrolling across the screen. Their donations to my Patreon campaign are a huge help to me and the channel. If you'd also like to have your name listed here, follow the link in the description to find my Patreon page. There are rewards and such. Down there you'll also find links to my Twitter, Twitch, and the channel's Discord server. Stuff often occurs in one or indeed all of those places, so go have a look. And if you want more content, I upload basically a video a day. Right, I'm out of time. Bye.